Hey, besties. I'm Lacey Shane, CEO of Real Women, Real Success. And it's a beautiful day in Southern California, so I'm coming to you from my backyard. And sorry for the sunglasses. I'll try to take them off. It's a little bright out, but I'm in the shade, so let's give this a shot because I want you to see my eyes, right? I want you to see the real woman. But today I wanted to talk a little bit about how to stay motivated as an aspiring entrepreneur. Both my husband and I have, we have three businesses, all marketed online, one product-based business, a jewelry company, and two training and coaching-based businesses. And we left 30-plus year careers, multiple six-figure incomes to become our own boss. And that is something that is becoming more and more common for several reasons. Because the gateway to entrepreneurship has never been wider. You can find almost any kind of information that you need or want by doing a search online. And there's a lot of people like me giving away information for free. Because why? Because when you really need someone, when you really make that commitment and get your business growing, there's a number of people like me who want to be there for you and hope that you'll choose us to support you in that process. So that's why I do these videos. And I'm also very passionate about women getting out there and doing what they love. And so there's a trend, in addition to the gateway being so wide and having so much ease of getting information to start your business, is that there are stats out there that talk about the employment industry or the field of employment as shrinking. So in just a year and a half, by 2020, the workforce will be made up 40% of people who are their own bosses, meaning independent contractors, own their own business, consultant type of folks, right? By 2030, that number shoots up 20% to 60%. So you're not alone. A lot of people are thinking of making this shift. It's a business model that works. I know as a CEO, there were certain companies I had where I only outsourced the different components of my company. A lot of what I did was either virtual or done with people who actually own their own company and specialize in certain areas of components of the businesses that I was running. So this is a logical move, right? Because you can have what you want and companies can get maybe even better service. And I know a lot of people think, you know, if I'm gonna work as hard as I'm working now in a career, then I'm gonna do it for myself. And that's certainly what I thought. But the fact is that, and I'm gonna put a little graphic right in the middle here of kind of a funny thing that I picked up along the way. That is the psychology of the entrepreneur from day to day. And it goes like this. And the thing that you need to realize is whether you're working now and thinking about starting a business or starting your business as a side gig or a side hustle while you're working, you're gonna have up and down days. That's normal. Think about just your whole path to what you do now professionally, right? You had learning days, you had days where you did really well, you had days where that didn't go so well. It's no different with entrepreneurship. But I'll tell you one interesting thing that I really think is important for you to think about in terms of staying motivated to pursue your dreams and become an entrepreneur. And that is, believe it or not, unless you have entrepreneurs in your family, and specifically entrepreneurs who are women who left careers to do this, right? That's what I specialize in, helping women who have like had a full-on career and now they want to do something either completely different or something on their own. The reaction to that among friends and family is often very negative, right? There's the reaction of, what are you doing? You have a great career, just stay in that. That's security, you know, collect your 401k or your pension or whatever, which not everybody has that, but a lot of people do. And this notion that you're sort of like crazy for pursuing your dream or whatever. You know, what's kind of funny about that is no one called us crazy when we were first in our careers trying to do something better, become something better, elevate in the workplace. Some of us went to school, so no one said, oh, you're stupid for going to school, or what are you doing leaving the comforts of your parents' home to go start a business, or I mean, I'm sorry, to start your career, because that's what everybody did. And that's my message to you. Not everybody leaves a long-term career to start a business, so they don't understand it. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with retiring and doing nothing but having fun the rest of your life. But a lot of us want to contribute in a bigger way. And that requires more growth, right? You can enjoy your life for the rest of your life if you don't need any more income and you don't want to make any bigger contribution and you have income to support that, then that's great, but that's not growth, right? A lot of people still want to grow. Growth is life. Growth is longevity, right? Growth is makes you more eternal. So my message to you today is to do what my husband and I have done, and that's we quit talking about our new businesses to people that were from our old careers, and even a lot of our friends who didn't understand, who were just going to have one career for their lives and that's it. We stopped talking to them about it because they really didn't understand the field we were going into. They didn't necessarily understand the full depth of online marketing and how incredibly lucrative it can be. And we found people to follow and to associate with who were really a support system for us, who were having the down days that we were having, who were having the technology challenges that we were having, who were questioning themselves like we did, right? And we've been in this 4 years and we're doing well, right? You go online and you hear a lot of people talk and they're like, you can be a millionaire overnight. I think that's, you know, I'm sorry, BS. Some people do it, you know, but it's results not normal. And, you know, it takes real dedication to get to $100,000 a year, which we're just over that in our businesses. So very, very thankful. But we've been working on it for 4 years, right? Very, very diligently. I will tell you that there's a huge upside to it. We've designed our businesses to work part-time. And while we have sprints where we're working a lot of hours, we're able to do the things we want. We're able to really accomplish the lifestyle, right? We're moving towards that we were hoping by starting our own businesses, but we wouldn't have been able to get there, and we won't be able to get any further because we plan to grow, you know, multiple times what our businesses are making now. And we're going to need those people that understand what we're doing, that have the same challenges, that can empathize with the struggles from day to day, the ups and downs, that can cheer us on and can really be there to help us and nurture us and maybe even point in the right direction, because everybody has different skills and talents to solve a problem that is really taking us down. So there are tons of people that you can follow on the internet as far as online marketing and starting businesses, tons of motivational people. And one of the reasons I wanted to make this video for you today is because I just watched one of the people I follow that I just think is phenomenal, both as a human being and as a business entrepreneur. And I was so motivated and I got so inspired just by watching him. So utilize those resources online. And I will tell you, women, I focus on women. I think women are smart and underutilized, and we have so much to offer, and we often give up those dreams for other people. So I just work with women, and I have a group of women all wanting to be entrepreneurs that we meet once a month online. If you're interested in more information on that, it's called Women Thriving in Business. Just feel free to email me. My email will be down below, but it's Lacey, L-A-C-Y, at LaceyShane.com, and L-A-C-Y-S-C-H-O-E-N.com. But mostly I just wanted to tell you, look, surround yourself with people that are doing what you want to do, that are starting businesses, that are struggling through figuring out how to do it, that are learning, that are getting the education and trying to make a new life for themselves. And surround yourself with those people, and you'll find yourself a lot more motivated, and you'll find out you're not alone with the things that you struggle with, okay? So I hope this was helpful today. Please give this video a like. If you'd like to subscribe to my email list, I send out resources. For instance, I have a financial planner. If you're looking to leave your job and start a business, I have a financial planner that will help you map out your financial trajectory to be able to do that, just like I did. It was actually the exact path that I followed. And if you have any questions, I gave you my email address. Glad to help. Glad to just converse with you and give you some support and feedback if you need it or want it, okay? Go out there and have a great week and kill it. And I'll see you next time.